The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... G. Marshall. Uncertainty, unfortunately, must always be the name of the game we are fated to play here below. Even the greatest book ever devised for our guidance can be used to support either side of an argument. Thus, we are told in one chapter, that which is crooked cannot be made straight. And in another, we are assured that the crooked shall be made straight. Well, since our concern at this time is with the crooked and the straight, you shall have the opportunity to decide for yourself.
I wish I could think of a way to raise money.
Go to a bank.
I don't think my credit's that good.
I didn't say go to a bank to borrow money.
But why else would I go?
Well, you can also go there to steal money.
To me? Rob a bank?
Sure.
Hey, who do you think I am?
I'll bet you that within 2 weeks, you'll say, okay, Walt, let's go rob that bank.
You're crazy.
Maybe. But that doesn't mean I'm wrong.
Our mystery drama, The Unthinkable, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Larry Haynes. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Sign-Off, the sinus medicines. I'll be back shortly with Act One. What did you do today? If this was a working day, was it very much different from what you did yesterday? Or from what you will do tomorrow? For so many people, life is a routine. Regular, predictable. And what did you believe yesterday? Is it different from what you believe today? When did you form your philosophy of life? When did you create your sense of values, your morality? When did you decide on what is right and what is wrong and where you would draw the line? Of course, there are those people who never make these decisions. They just go along from day to day and see what turns up.
Walt?
The man himself.
You're late.
Yeah.
Twins couldn't wait up.
I'm sorry.
Kids should always be able to say goodnight to Daddy, So how'd it go today?
Well, there was this ad. I'd been trying to reach the guy all day, finally caught him at 4:30. Come out to see me right now, he said. I drove all the way to East Wellington.
Did you get the...
No, I didn't get the job.
I'm sorry.
You want to know something? I don't think I'll ever get a job.
I guess you're right. I don't think you're ever going to get a job.
Now, how can you say a thing like
that? Why not? You just said it.
Well, I can say it. I have the right to say it, but nobody else does.
Walt, you've been out of work for 16 months.
15. Don't you have any faith in my ability?
Your ability to do what?
Roxanne, what kind of conversation are we having?
A realistic conversation. I go by the record, by the facts.
Roxy, what am I supposed to think?
You are supposed to think, I would imagine, how to best spend your time without working at a job. What other useful function might you perform?
The only useful function I can perform is to earn enough money to support this family.
Darling, obviously you can't do it.
Are you trying to destroy my morale?
I'm only stating the truth.
If I can't support this family, who can? We have 6-year-old twins. Do you propose to send them to work?
Well, I solved the problem.
You did? And may I ask how?
I got a job.
You got a what?
A job.
What do you mean you got a job?
A job. A situation. Employment.
Roxy, how could you get a job? You never worked a day in your life.
That has nothing to do with it. I discovered something today. You know what this entire situation is all about.
Oh.
There are those people who know how to get jobs and those who don't.
Really?
Now, you have been looking for almost a year and a half, and what's the result? Nothing. On the other hand, I go out, and in the first hour of the first day, at the first place I applied, I found it.
Uh-huh. And what did you get? Some job as a waitress, for crying out loud?
No. I got a job in a bank. as assistant to the manager.
Now, what are you talking about? What do you know about money?
Well, that's what the man asked me. You know what I told him? I said, I know how to spend it. One thing led to another, and he said, unorthodox approaches and unorthodox people are what we need today. And so I start tomorrow, 9 to 3.
Well, you can't.
Why not?
Well, the kids get home from school at 1. Who's going to be here?
You are.
Me?
Well, you're not working.
Well, I can't stay home and take care of the kids.
You would be surprised how rewarding it is. I know. I've had 6 years of it.
But I'm an engineer.
Of course.
A graduate engineer. I'm a bachelor of science in electrical engineering.
And it's trained you to be very efficient. That means you'll clean the house faster and better than I ever could.
Now look here, Roxy. It's not my job to mind the kids and clean the house.
Whose job is it?
Well, it's yours.
Where does it say so?
Roxy, you can't ask me to hold still for your taking a job if it means I have to sit home.
Darling, I am not the one who's asking you. In reality, it is the landlord who's asking you, the grocer, the butcher.
Now, this is unthinkable.
I was brought up in a family and in a tradition where men worked at their jobs and women ran the house. Well, whatever the past, this was the present. And very likely the future. She had me. Our savings were just about gone. And what else could I do? Surprisingly, I did a good job. I organized that house. The cleaning, the marketing, the cooking. And I did it all in less than half the time it took her. And truthfully, I did it twice as good. And it wasn't very long before I discovered that I wasn't the only one in that boat. If it was a nice day, I'd go to the park and read a book on electronics. After all, I did have to keep up with the field. He was about my age. And he wheeled a little 2-year-old in a stroller. We started to talk one day. He was an architect. He couldn't find a job either.
It's not so bad, Walter.
Oh, what are you saying,
well,
Phil?
So many of the things in our lives in this world, so many things are done in a certain way. And for no other reason than this is the way they've always been done.
No. Look, if you're going to start to say what I think you're going to say, drop it, huh?
This being an architect, I mean the doing, the creating, it's fine, it's wonderful. But the business of being an architect, the politics, the competing, the games you have to play with clients... I always hated it.
That's all part of it, Phil.
Business. Now, that's for Gloria. She thrives on it. She's with an ad agency, and already she's making more money than I ever did.
Now, what are you going to do? Throw in a towel? Spend the rest of your life doing this?
I'm relaxing. I'm reading. I'm enjoying life.
Oh, sure.
I have time for books.
So did I, at first. But wait. You've only had a month of it.
I've been browsing through the library, been looking up the plans of some of the historic buildings in the city. Hey, you know the Central National Bank, the oldest one in town?
No.
Well, come on, of course you do. Your wife works there.
Oh, you see, psychologically, I reject it.
Do you know there's an old sewer system that runs directly below their vault?
No, I didn't know that.
That's very interesting.
Is that a fact? I don't find it at all interesting.
You see, the bank used to be served by the old system till they built the new one, 40 years ago. And the entrance into the cellar of the bank has been closed off by a single metal plate.
Now, let's see. What am I going to serve tonight?
Now, all someone would have to do to get to the cellar vault is to find a way into that old sewer tunnel.
Now, which supermarket is running a special on fish?
And I looked up the old map, and I found the easiest place of access to that sewer.
Fish. And I'll make broccoli.
Would you believe it's in the middle of the street just outside the police station? Walt, the entrance?
Uh-huh. I'll make a vinaigrette and fruit salad.
Yeah, and from there, the tunnel leads you to the bank. It's less than 3 blocks away. So any resourceful bank robber...
If there's no fish, I can get chicken.
You know, I can tell you're not interested. You didn't hear a word I said.
You know something? That's what I thought. But the fact is, even though I didn't realize it, I heard every word he said. Even as he said it, without being aware of it, I knew what I wanted to do. Do what? Break into that vault, of course. You know, so many things we decide without really being aware of the moment of decision. So many things that are unthinkable to our conscious mind have already been made acceptable by the secret sector of our being that determines the course of our lives. But as I say, I was not yet aware that I had made a decision, especially such a decision. Robbery. Why, that was unthinkable. Or so I thought. Until I had to meet her up at the bank one day. They were going to give her a dinner to celebrate, what do you suppose? Her promotion. She had just been given a raise and a better job. And there was this old geezer, one of the guards. Pop.
Can I help you?
Yes, I am looking for Mrs. Robinson's office.
Yeah. Okay, I'll tell her somebody wants to see her. What's your name?
I'm Mr. Robinson.
Huh?
I'm her husband.
Well, you can't be her... okay, I'll tell her you're here.
Now, wait a minute. What made you say I can't be her husband?
Well, I didn't say that.
Well, you started to say it. Why?
Well, we just didn't figure she'd be married to a big, strapping guy like you. I bet you must weigh 220. You're at least 6'3". We figured, well...
What did you figure?
You'd have to be a little bit of a guy, kind of skinny with glasses.
Why?
Why? I don't know why.
Because I stay home while she works. Is that it? Because I clean and cook and mind the kids. Is that it? And that's not a man's job.
Well, I never said... Now, look, Mr. Robinson, I talk out of turn a lot. You can ask anybody. But I don't mean no harm.
Yeah, well, will you tell Mrs. Robinson that I can't join her this evening? And I'll see her at home. Maybe. Hello, 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 hello. And how did the dinner go? Hey, that rhymes.
You're drunk.
And what if I am?
You better go to bed. We'll talk about it in the morning.
You see, I didn't want to get loaded in public. After all, my wife is an officer in a bank. And how would it look if her husband got tanked up?
I said we would talk in the morning.
Now, what's there to talk about?
I was embarrassed by the fact that it was my dinner and you couldn't be there.
Well, of course. Of course, especially since being Mr. Nobody, it would never occur to anyone that maybe I might have something important to do, that maybe I had a career that could possibly make demands of me.
Walter, you are not sober enough for us to have any sort of conversation.
Well, I guess they all had a pretty good laugh at my expense back there at the old bank.
That isn't true.
I bet they all say to you at the office, what a great wife you must have at home, Mrs. Robinson. Did you say his name was Walter?
Oh, please, Walt, this isn't getting us anywhere.
But the joke's on you, too, don't you see it? They're also laughing at you because in their eyes, if I've become less of a man, then also you have to be less of a woman.
Walter, darling, please, you're making a mountain out of a molehill.
Which is what has to happen. Why are we leading this unnatural existence?
It is not an unnatural...
Money. You have to go out and make it because I can't get a job. Well, there's more than one way to skin a cat. Why did I say that? You know how I love animals.
Walt, please go to bed. You're not really a drinking man.
Oh, I have to go out. I am embarking on a great adventure.
At this hour?
Well, of course. When Columbus said to his wife, my dear, I'm going off to discover America, did she say, at this hour?
But where are you going?
I know a place where I can make a fortune.
Is that the place we're thinking of? Of course. Where else? Is it conceivable that he intends to rob the bank where she works? Sure. Does he intend to do it now? Tonight? There are some questions we simply refuse to answer until Act Two rolls around. Anna shall be here in just a few moments. Those people who walk the straight and narrow path all their lives, who never budge an inch from the code of virtue, who never stray from their principles, who never falter from their convictions, well, those are just the people who can fool you. Pay close attention.
right. All right, I hear you. I'm coming. Who is it?
It's me, Phil, Walt.
Walt? Walt, do you know what time it is?
It's 2:45.
In the morning.
And it's beautiful out. There's a silver glow in the sky. An eloquent silence lies over the earth.
What do you want?
I want to come in.
Walt, you're drunk.
Mm-hmm. I'm intoxicated. With insight, wisdom, perception.
Mm-hmm. You want a cup of coffee?
No.
It's a lucky thing Gloria's visiting her sister.
Why? Would she object? Do we have to worry about Gloria because she is the one that pays the rent now?
I am here to offer you a job.
What kind of a job?
Robbing a bank?
You're crazy. Where'd you get this ridiculous idea?
From you.
Now I know you're crazy. Look, you want me to drive you home?
No. Maybe we better have that coffee. You need time.
Time? What does time have to do with it? Walt, I would never break the law.
Yes, you would, and you will.
Look at us. Two highly qualified and talented professionals, and we're out of work.
I would not violate the structures of society.
Society? What does society care about us? Society owes us the right to have jobs.
Oh, come on, Walter. No one has the right to be a criminal.
All right. Let's assume that that's true.
Well, it is. Let me tell you.
No. Let me tell you. You are being devastated by the role you're being forced to play just as I am.
Walt, I don't think there's any point to this argument.
Phil, I am here to save your manhood. You're an architect. You were meant to build homes, mighty towers of art and commerce and industry, cathedrals. You can't be satisfied washing baby diapers.
Now, look. My wife was summa cum laude at college. She won an international essay award. She's brilliant. Should she be imprisoned in a house with the diapers?
Now, don't start saying those things. You'll start believing them, and then you'll be lost. Sure, the world is unfair. It's always been unfair. It's been catastrophically unfair, especially to women, sure. But no woman, not even my own wife, is going to hand me the bill for 10,000 years of injustice and say, here, you pay for it.
All right, Walt, I don't mind. Use me as a sounding board. Get things off your chest.
My wife will not support me.
Look, let's see about the car.
We should be ready to rob the bank in about 2 weeks.
No! Walt, I couldn't do it. I want no part of it.
Then why did you suggest it?
But that's what you said before. When did I ever suggest it?
Oh, a week, 10 days ago, we were sitting in a park, and you told me about the abandoned sewer tunnel that led into the cellar of the Central National Bank. Now, why?
Well, because it was an architectural curiosity.
Yeah, but why that one? This town is loaded with architectural curiosities. Why an abandoned sewer that leads into a bank?
Well...
And I said, who cares? And you said bank robbers would find it interesting.
Walt, I never said any...
But you did. Now, why? Because the minute you read about it, the white-hot idea flashed through your brain.
Oh. You're...
Yeah, now why? Why? Why did you tell me about it? You were looking for a partner.
This is ridiculous.
Maybe, but that doesn't mean it isn't true. And you found the ideal partner in me. Because I happen to be an electrical engineer. You're the architect. You can find us the way in. But getting there is only half the fun. An electronics expert like me would be able to neutralize the alarm systems.
Walter, I can assure you nothing. Nothing like that even entered.
And to top it off, my wife works there. She not only works there, she's an executive. And I could find out strategic information about that alarm system.
Walter... You'd better leave.
No, this is the most important decision you'll ever have to make, Phil. So you sleep on it, huh?
I can only tell you this. It's unthinkable.
Yeah, I know. Yes, it was unthinkable. For about a week and a half. Which is par for the course. We met, as usual, on the park bench. And we talked about trivia, as usual.
This fella's going to sign with the Blue Sox for $250,000 a year. Do you think they get all that, or is it just talk?
Oh, who knows?
Don't they have to pay a fortune in taxes?
Who cares?
When do you want to rob the bank?
On the first of the month.
Yeah. I rechecked the plans. The seal-off plate of the old sewer is exactly under the vault. Now, one problem. Mm. The alarm system. The outside of the vault, everything leading down to it from the bank, and the bank itself, is wired.
Yeah, we know that.
But what about the inside of the vault?
Just leave that to me. More dessert, darling?
No, dear.
Just a little, huh? I made this special.
And I can't resist, but I'm gaining weight.
Oh, it's a plot. I want to make sure you're as unattractive as possible.
Oh, Walt. Do you think I'd ever look at another man?
Well, I want to make sure another man never looks at you.
You know, something's come over you these past few days. You seem very calm and, yes, fulfilled.
Well, maybe it's because I'm out of the rat race.
Oh, I can't tell you how happy I am. I never suspected my talent for business. I just take to banking as if I were destined for it.
Well, I'm glad, darling. More pie?
Oh, just a teeny piece.
And you know, I'm happy, too, right here in the house. I have so much time for myself to think, read, study. You know, I should never have become an engineer.
Why, darling?
Well, I was always clever with my hands and good in math. So my folks said, let's make an engineer out of him. But you know what I really am? An inventor.
Well, that's marvelous. And now you have the opportunity
to...
Yeah. Oh, how beautifully things have worked out. Are you thinking of any kind of... the particular thing?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I have a fantastic idea for a detection device.
Wonderful. What is it?
Yeah, you're adorable. You know, right now, it's nothing but some formulae in calculus, but I think it's revolutionary. I have one problem, however.
A problem?
Yeah, now, wait. Maybe you can help me.
Oh, darling, if there's anything I can do.
Yeah, you see... my knowledge of detection devices, I mean on a very highly sophisticated level, is at best theoretical, see?
Uh-huh.
And there'd be no way for me to examine the makeup of... unless I could see the one at your bank.
Ours?
Yeah. But I can tell, by the way that you said that it wouldn't be a good idea.
Oh, darling, it's a marvelous idea.
Well, then why did you hesitate?
Well, I was just caught off guard by the idea that I could be of help to you. Would it be helpful?
Gee, now that I think of it... Roxy, how would it look? Show my husband the alarm system. I mean, you know.
Well, now, in the first place, I practically run the day-to-day business at that branch. And secondly, my husband is a highly skilled electronics technician.
Now, don't demote me, darling. I'm not a technician. I'm an engineer.
Oh, sweetheart, I didn't mean it. Well, you come in and talk with Ben Kennedy first thing tomorrow, after you get the kids off to school.
Not only marriages, but... propositions, deals, ventures are also made in heaven. You know, I really couldn't believe how smoothly this thing was going. Ben Kennedy was one of the big wheels in charge of security. He was glad to see me, almost pathetically glad. Obviously, very few people ever came to see him or solicited his opinion. I learned more about burglar alarms than I could ever hope to use in a lifetime. But I had to hold still for it because sooner or later, I would decently be able to ask the one key question. Now, what you're telling me, Ben, is absolutely fantastic, but now take your cellar vault.
Yeah?
Is that live also?
Oh, sure.
Oh.
Now, figure you've got crooks smart enough to neutralize all the alarms leading downstairs.
Mm-hmm.
Figure they can open the vault.
Yeah.
Well... you see this plan?
Mm.
Once they step inside, we have circuits.
Ah.
Yeah, these little beams of invisible lights.
Uh-huh.
No way they can take two steps inside without breaking a circuit and activating an alarm. A silent one.
Oh, hey, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, but now, look, suppose you have to do some work or repairs down there at night. How do you, deactivate that system?
You can't.
Oh. Well, suppose someone has to work at night.
You can't from inside the bank. That's the beauty of it. These crooks. They're clever. They can figure out where the main box for the alarm is located. They think When they disconnect that, they're home free. But the control for the vault, that's outside.
Oh.
Yeah, in back of the building, right beneath the electric meter. You can hardly see it. Who'd think to look? You know, a small box?
Sure.
You just open it, turn the switch.
Well, hey, that certainly is the cleverest idea.
Yeah, yeah. Look, is there anything else I can tell you?
Well, I guess you've told me everything.
Why Friday night?
Because the bank is closed Saturday and Sunday. Nobody will miss anything till after the weekend. Now, about your wife.
She thinks you and I are going bowling.
Okay, that checks with my story.
Yeah.
Now, getting in is your department, though. How do we do it?
Well, according to these plans...
Mm-hmm.
How beautifully they sketched them in the old days. A work of art. Well, anyway, there's a manhole in the middle of the street in front of the police station.
Right.
We go down, we move 600 feet.
Mm-hmm.
On the right is a sealed plate. That separates the new sewer system from the old one. We remove the plate,
mm-hmm.
and we are now in the old system.
Ah.
Now, 300 feet south is the plate that separates the old system from the vault. We remove that plate...
Now, just a minute. How are we going to get down the manhole carrying all kinds of tools in clear view of the police station? You got cops looking out of every window.
There is absolutely nothing to it.
Are you crazy? No, he wasn't crazy. Do you know what we did? We hired a half-ton pickup truck, some iron railings, a sign that said men at work. And bold as brass, we stopped right in the middle of the street in front of the police station and set up shop. And you want to know something else? It was midnight. They were even changing shifts. And don't you know, there was a sharp, smart, veteran-looking sergeant. Even sauntered over to the manhole where we were putting up the rail and the sign. And he said...
You guys working late, huh?
The city's a hard mistress.
You can say that again. What are you going down there for?
We're looking for buried treasure.
Well, now, you got to realize that everything you find, you have to turn over to the property clerk's office.
All right, how about if we split it with you instead, huh, Sarge?
can you cut in the lieutenant, too?
Yeah, sure, there's enough for everybody.
See if you can find me some of them pieces of eight, huh?
Yeah, coming up. Well, Phil and I went down into that manhole, just like Alice went down into the rabbit hole. And there we were, in a wonderland of tunnels. Do people really know what goes on underneath the very streets they walk on? Without any trouble at all, we made our way to the plate that closed this sewer off from the old one. With very little trouble, we removed the plate and entered the ancient and abandoned sewer. With even less trouble, we found the plate that separated the tunnel from the bank vault. And with practically no trouble, we removed the plate. And there we were, in the cellar vault of the Central National Bank. And there, all around us, was money. And Phil could hardly believe it.
Walt.
What is it?
Is it possible? Is it possible? Can it really be so easy? Can it?
Well, can it? You must admit there hasn't been a hitch so far. Well, now, what do our boys have to do? Simply fill their sacks with as much money as they can carry and go out the same way they came in. However, you know that Act 3 will bring storms in just a few moments. There's nothing as damaging to the psyche as being stolid and set in one's ways, poured in a mold, as it were. People should be adaptable, flexible, willing and able to adjust to the demands of any situation. Well, how do you like Walt and Phil? Two gentlemen who have always been honest to the core, and here they are robbing a bank with a skill and finesse worthy of the most seasoned professionals.
Walt, is it possible?
Sure.
But it can't be this easy.
Well, what are you...
Why are we whispering? Who can hear us? We're alone in the vault, the cash vault of the Central National Bank.
Look at the money, the money.
Yeah, stacks and piles of money.
Oh, load the sacks.
Yeah, wait now.
What?
Now, just take money we can spend easily. No hundreds, no fifties. Tens and twenties.
You're right. You're absolutely right.
Yeah, let's not be pigs.
Yeah.
Let's not be greedy.
That's right. This is just tide us over till we can get jobs.
Right.
Now, let's see. $1 million would be...
That would be 100,000 tens,
right.
50,000 twenties.
Yeah, that's a lot of...
All right, just fill the sacks. No. Don't bother with those. Those are only fives.
You know, Walt, I don't know if we can carry $1 million worth.
So we'll take half a million. What's the problem?
Wow, is it going to feel great?
Yeah.
Not having to ask her for money.
Oh, it's going to be a new world. All right. I think we got enough.
Look, I can still get more.
No. Look, if we run short, we can always come back.
You're right.
Sure.
How much do you think we have?
Half a million.
Quarter of a million apiece. It's not bad.
Well, it'll do for starters. Okay, Phil, let's beat it.
Okay, look. Just hold it a second.
What?
Who's...
Pop. That's Pop, the guard.
Yes. Oh. Guilty as charged. Don't nobody move. This here gun. You see this here gun?
Oh, yeah, sure. We see it.
Now, this here gun is a .357 Magnum.
Oh, yeah. That's quite a gun. What are you doing down here, Pop?
What am I doing down here? I guess there's something Ben Kennedy didn't tell you.
Ben Kennedy?
I seen you and Kennedy putting your heads together, so I just kind of sauntered over and...
I didn't notice you.
Nobody ever notices old Pop. He just sort of blends in with the furniture. But old Pop here, he notices everybody, and he listens to everybody. Now, why else would you want to know about the alarm system if you wasn't figuring on a heist?
Now, you said Ben Kennedy didn't tell me something. What didn't he tell me?
Maybe he didn't know. Maybe he forgot. But what he didn't say was, if anybody's in the vault after hours, a little red light goes on in the guard's room.
Oh.
Yeah, oh.
Yeah, listen, Pop, what are you going to do with us, huh?
How can you ask that question, son? I'm an officer of the law. I have a duty to uphold.
Yeah, Pop, what'll happen if you turn us over to the police? Now, each of us has a wife, children.
You should have thought of that.
Oh, Pop, don't say that. Now, don't you say that. Not you. That's for those people without hearts, without feelings.
I still got my duty, fella.
Is it your duty to destroy our lives?
That's why they're paying me.
But are they paying you enough, Pop? What do you get, huh? You stand guard over their millions, and what do you get in return? A pittance. You carry a gun on your hip. Your life is always up for grabs. Suppose we were veterans, huh? Ruthless killers, experienced and filled with savvy. Could you have surprised us? No. We'd have been waiting for you, Pop, and you'd have been dead by now.
There's something to what you say.
Yeah, now, Pop, there has to be some give and take in life. You can't be a fanatic, an extremist.
Well, I've always been a reasonable fella. What was that give you were talking about?
We got a half a million in these sacks, Pop.
Are you trying to bribe me?
No, please, Pop, don't get angry.
I'll take half.
You got a deal.
You gotta tie me up now. Put a gag in my mouth.
Now, Pop, you don't have a worry in the world.
How about the dough?
It'll be waiting for you, Pop. You just make a date. Come around and collect it any time.
I trust you, Walter. You've got that look in your eye.
All right. An unforeseen development. But men of goodwill basically can resolve all their differences. We replaced the cellar plate, retraced our steps through the sewers, emerged at the manhole with our tools and our sacks. I went home and hid the money in the safest place in the world until we could make plans to dispose of it properly. And so to bed, where I slept the deep, dreamless, peaceful sleep of the just until my wife woke me.
Walter, there's been a robbery at the bank.
What? Oh.
gosh, how awful.
From one of the guards, you know, that nice old one. Pop didn't come home after his shift. His wife became worried. She phoned, and they found him in the vault, bound and gagged.
Oh, that's terrible, darling. What is the city coming to? A person isn't even safe in a bank.
Well, they said there's nothing I can do, but I am so upset, and I'm so nervous and so angry.
All right, darling. Here, let me make you a cup of coffee.
Keep out of my way. I'm not myself. I explode at trifles.
Hi.
Oh, come in, Phil.
Where's the doll?
It's all right. You can talk. The kids are with their grandparents, and Roxy's upstairs.
Yeah, okay. So, where's the doll?
And this'll kill you. In the garbage can, outside, in the yard.
The garbage?
Yeah, now, Phil, look. They only pick it up Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Is there a safer place for a sack of money, huh?
I don't know where else we could keep it.
Well, I had to stash it somewhere when I came in.
When can we...
Yeah, right now. Roxy is asleep. No one is home. So let's go out to the yard. Hold it.
Who could that be?
What do you mean, who could that be? This is a normal house. We do get phone calls. It could be anybody. Hello?
Bring that money back here. I'll let you get away with it.
Mr. Kennedy?
Yeah. Ben Kennedy, you made a sap out of me, Buster. All you wanted to do was find out how to deactivate the alarm.
Now, Ben, I can assure you...
Look, I went outside to look at the box. The switch had been thrown. Now, who else knew except you and me?
Ben, I can assure you...
I will give you 5 minutes to get here. If you don't, I'll call the police.
All right, Ben. How much do you want?
Are you trying to bribe me?
Well, sure.
I warn you, return the money.
But you can't prove anything.
I can communicate my suspicions, Buster. The police will do the rest. I can have them out to your house in 3 minutes before you can even hide that money.
Now, Mr. Kennedy, I don't know what you're talking about.
Trouble?
Ben Kennedy, he's wise.
Oh, we have to hide that money.
Relax, it's hidden now.
But are you sure that...
Look, where else?
Walt? Oh, hi, Phil.
Hello, Roxy.
I am mad enough to chew nails this morning. Everything goes wrong at the same time.
Now, darling, the bank is not your fault.
Something is wrong with the boiler. There's no hot water. The kids got jam on the Persian rug. And look at how the garbage is piled up in the backyard. Don't you ever notice these things?
Well, dear,
Don't you ever complain to these people? We pay them to remove our garbage.
All right, darling. So they missed out on one day.
I work hard for my money, and I won't let anyone...
Now, dear, aren't you taking this too seriously?
That's because you don't take it seriously enough. If you had to pay the bills around here...
Who are you calling?
Who do you think I'm calling? The scavenger.
But why?
He's going to come over here and do what he gets paid for.
Oh, no, not now.
Why?
Well, because it's Saturday. They don't work on Saturdays.
Hello. This is Mrs. Robinson, Waverly Drive. You didn't pick up my garbage yesterday.
Oh.
I am not interested in your excuses. We have a contract. I want that garbage picked up now.
Roxy.
I don't care if the men are off and the truck is in the garage. Get into your limousine and pick it up yourself. And right now, or I'll do business elsewhere.
Oh, now, darling, you shouldn't have, Phil.
Yeah,
What has gotten into the two of you?
We'll remove it, the garbage.
We'll take care of the whole thing. We'll take it to the dump ourselves.
You do no such thing. I pay a scavenger. Oh, now, who's that?
Well, I don't know, darling. Now, look, Phil and I have some errands to run.
What kind of errands?
Well, you know, men's stuff.
Well, will you answer the door first?
Yeah, sure thing. Come on, Phil. We'll go out the front way.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, I'm coming.
You Walter Robinson?
Yes, Sergeant, I am.
And, who's this?
This is a friend of mine.
Yeah, a friend of his.
Both of you, stand over by the wall.
What is the meaning of this?
You, Ms. Robinson?
Yes.
We got a tip to search the house.
For what reason?
For the money that was stolen from the bank last night.
I'm an officer of that bank.
Lady, that's how it is.
Well, have you got a warrant?
No, but what we have got is probable cause.
Well, I can insist on a warrant. I know my rights.
You'll insist on nothing of the sort.
But I have rights.
What have we got to hide? When a bank is robbed, all employees are suspect, or should be. So go right ahead, Sergeant. You won't find anything.
Okay, boys. Step lively and lightly.
Say, is it all right if I go outside, Sarge?
You know, you look familiar to me. I can't place you. And your voice.
I can't go back in the yard, can't I?
What for?
Well, to smoke. Smoke a cigarette. You see, we don't smoke in the house.
You don't? What are these ashtrays for?
Oh, stop it, Walt. Don't try to give people the idea that I henpeck you. You can smoke anywhere you like, within reason.
Just stay put, pal.
Yeah, well. Hey, what's that?
Aha! The garbage truck.
What?
You see, I scared him. He got the truck down here. That's how you have to talk to people. Mm-hmm. You see how he's picking up every scrap of garbage? Emptying all the cans?
Well, he can't. He can't do that. He can't pick up the garbage. Not yet.
Why not?
Well, because...
What are you so nervous about? All morning you've been so jumpy.
Yeah, what are you so nervous about, pal? You know, I never forget a face. Where have I seen you before? Maybe my imagination. It's very helpful of you to cooperate with the police.
Hey, the garbage truck, it's leaving.
What do you want him to do, stay here?
We won't inconvenience you any longer than we have to. You know, I wonder, where have I seen you before?
The garbage truck. It's been here and it's gone. The stuff has been dumped.
Oh, hide it in the garbage. In the garbage. What a great idea.
But where else was I going to hide it?
Look what happened.
Well, the garbage was the only place they didn't search. If I'd have hidden it anywhere else, they'd have found it. It's all your fault.
My fault?
Yeah, why didn't you hold on to the money? Nobody suspected you. You were scared.
Are we going to stand here all day and yell at one another, or are we going to look for the money?
Look for the money?
Yeah.
Look for the money? There's acres. There's miles of garbage. Garbage as far as the eye can see and the nose can smell. There's just garbage. How can we hope to find a couple of sacks?
Walt, we are not going to find anything if we don't start. You ready?
Oh, yes. They're looking, examining, sifting, poking, probing. They come every day. After all, they have nothing else to do. To the men who work here, Walt and Phil are a familiar sight. A couple of nuts, but nice. And of course, each day the refuse is piled higher and deeper, and the search is that much harder. But whoever said $500,000 grows on trees? I'll return shortly. We try to have something for everyone. For those who like stories of bank heists and capers, we have a tale of a simple robbery. For those who seek social significance, we were exploring the changing roles of men and women in our society. And for those who are intrigued by standards of morality, this has been an exercise in the unthinkable. Our cast included Larry Haynes, Terry Keane, Russell Horton, and Robert Maxwell. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Sinoff, the Sinus Medicines, and Buick Motor Division. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.